Hello researchers, welcome to another pharmacology research video. Today we are going to be talking about a slightly different compound today, not a cognitive enhancer, but a lifespan enhancer. This compound goes by the name Indolepropionamide, or IPAM. IPAM is a small molecule indole derivative which is similar in structure to melatonin. IPAM is found endogenously in mammals and serves mainly as a free radical scavenger. How does it work, you may ask? In studies, IPAM was shown to increase complex 1 and complex 4 activity in the mitochondrial electron transport chain. However, it does not affect complex 2 or 3. IPAM can also act as a recyclable electron and proton carrier, facilitating reversible endogenous radical and redox reactions, and thereby enabling the formation of a proton gradient that drives mitochondrial ATP synthesis. Thus, IPAM acts as a stabilizer of energy metabolism in mitochondria, thereby reducing the production of reactive oxygen species. IPAM is a very novel compound, only having one major study to date. It has not yet been tested on rats or other animals, which is unfortunate. However, we can still derive a lot from the current study. IPAM was tested on rotifiers, which are basically millimeter-sized swimming animals, and they are used in early-stage studies for testing. IPAM-treated rotifers had a lifespan extended by approximately 300%. The number of offsprings increased by 3.4 times and body length increased by 1.47 times in comparison with IPAM-untreated rotifers. Such a lifespan extension in this particular rotifer species is the highest that was ever observed to date in any study, potentially being the most lifespan-enhancing compound ever discovered. For IPAM's approximate lifespan enhancement in mice, we can calculate using other lifespan enhancers. As an example, rapamycin enhanced 35% longer. Mean lifespans in rotifiers in a study by Terry W. Snell, and on average enhances lifespan in mice by 15-20% averaged across studies. We can make the approximate judgment that IPAM most likely enhances lifespan by at least 150% in mice. Mitochondrial protecting compounds seem to have a higher upside than mTOR modulating compounds, which were the previous main target in pharmacology, with compounds like rapamycin. The authors of the IPAM study also published another study using a similar mitochondrial protector named LPBNA. It seems to have slightly less efficacy than IPAM, but it still makes a significant difference. It is unknown whether they can be combined and if that would be effective. For IPAM's pharmacokinetic profile, it seems to be superior to some similar compounds. IPAM is found endogenously in mammals, so that brings some level of safety to begin with compared to synthetic compounds. And on top of that, IPAM has a long half-life and no pro-oxidant activity. In addition, the approximate human dosage is in the milligram range, and considering the compound itself is quite small, it should not be too expensive if used in humans. Saying that, it still only has one study on rotifiers, so human usage should be done with caution. In conclusion, IPAM is a very interesting compound that deserves more attention and research. It is multiple times more effective than other lifespan enhancers, and it is the most effective lifespan enhancer in rotifiers to date. Thanks for watching, my fellow researchers, and subscribe to join the Kamaru Army. Leave a comment if you have ultimate swag. See you in the next one.